Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's video will begin by us taking a little look at the recent return of Bob Benkhen and Doug Hurley. Then, you all know what's next, we have Boca Chica update Starship SN5 in its first hop, as well as future Starship pieces to look at. Let's head straight in and get up to date. As you will probably all be aware, on Sunday, August 2nd, Dragon Ship Endeavour carrying Bob and Doug splashed down off the shore of Pensacola. Such a fantastic mission and a fantastic landing. As I mentioned recently, next for this Crew Dragon will be to fly astronauts on the Crew 2 mission. Expected to launch in spring of 2021, Bob's wife will be one of the NASA astronauts aboard the capsule next. Though, there will be one other NASA, one JAXA and one ESA astronaut flying on Crew 2 as well. With the men, there was an American flag that was also returned to Earth for the first time in 9 years. Launched aboard STS-135, the final space shuttle mission, the flag was left on the ISS. It remained there until now, when the next American capsule returns to Earth. It will then fly to space again with the astronauts who fly with the Artemis program. So, on Sunday, after splashdown, SpaceX's boat named Go Navigator was waiting to go and pick up Endeavour. Here, we have a great shot from Kyle Montgomery of the recovery vessel returning to the Pensacola port. Very excited for when this capsule launches for the second time. Now, we will check out the stuff happening over in Boca Chica, and to start with, we have a little bit of unfortunate news. We saw this a bit last episode, but here is a better view of the wall SpaceX are currently in the process of erecting. Depending on how much of the test area will be surrounded by the wall, we will probably not be able to see as much of what is going on. However, I'm sure there will be plenty of other stuff for Mary to film. Recently, we've been seeing engineers working on the Starhopper vehicle. Well, now there's a pump that has been connected to where they've been doing the modifications. Last episode, we saw a transport mount which had some lighting attached to the bottom, as well as some activity with the roll lift. Here you can see that workers were spotted lifting the mount onto the roll lift. Then, the mount atop the roll lift was seen sitting over by the tracking area of the facility. I'm wondering what, if anything, they might be planning to put on display, but keep in mind that the assumptions about it being for display are just that, assumptions. As always, we're constantly seeing all sorts of components in Boca Chica. Here we have some sitting on a trailer near the solar farm. Over by the production area of the facility, there was also another new component on a trailer spotted arriving. Then we have a really cool arrival that was also spotted. Here we have some tarped Starship fins. Will be interesting to see which prototype they'll be attached to, and I sort of want to say maybe SN8. With those usual Boca Chica updates covered, let's move on to the action with Starship prototypes. As I mentioned last episode for the SN5 hop, SpaceX did have a date for Sunday, but obviously with Crew Dragon splashdown, that had to be the priority. However, during the day, the tank farm was seen doing a bit of venting. The following day, Monday, August 3rd, the company continued to work near the pad for the majority of the window. Then, some 3 or 4 hours before the end of the hop window, the pad started to clear and the road closed. Half an hour before the first hop attempt, there was a tweet from Elon Musk in response to a tweet from Everyday Astronaut. Musk said the attempt would be in approximately 33 minutes. Then, around 35 minutes after the tweet, activity by the tank farm had picked up and the prototype itself started venting. Then, we were expecting the 150m hop to begin until nothing. However, you can see that the tank did try to lift off but automatically aborted. With just 1 hour remaining in the test window after the abort, the chances of a recycle and another attempt were slim but still possible. Whilst the expectation was optimistic, there was some venting that happened but no more hop attempts. Just before the end of the road closure and window, Elon Musk hopped on Twitter and responded to a tweet from Chris Burgin about the abort. He said that the issue was due to a Raptor turbopump spin start valve didn't open, triggering an automatic abort. Then he said, "We'll figure out why and retry tomorrow." So, tomorrow rolls round, and sure enough, before midday, SpaceX began all the steps for preparing to hop this machine. Until, well yeah, there was another abort, presumably an automatic abort. Musk responded to a tweet from Everyday Astronaut a bit later on to say that there would most likely be another attempt. Throughout the day, engineers headed back to the pad and worked diligently to get a fix implemented as soon as possible. Once they had finished up their work, the pad was once again cleared and SpaceX were good to go to retry the hop. Then, some minutes before the test was to happen, Musk tweeted that there was 3 minutes to go. Then finally, it happened, the moment we've been waiting for months. SN5 lifted off. I'm just going to let the video play and let you take it all in. Then, some hours after the test had concluded, Musk took to Twitter to let us know what's next. When asked about what's on the agenda next, Musk responded with, "We'll do several hops to smooth out launch process, then go high altitude with body flaps." Also, something Musk mentioned as well in terms of the legs was, version 1.1 legs will be approximately 60% longer. Version 2 legs will be much wider and taller, like Falcon, but capable of landing on unimproved surfaces and auto-leveling. Yesterday, I couldn't believe what I had just watched. It's one thing seeing a smaller test tank, or should we say water tower, fly. It's another thing when there's a taller grain silo with an offset Raptor engine doing the same test. I cannot wait until this thing gets a nose with canards and fins. It's going to look incredible. It only gets better from here. With that, let's finally take a look at other existing and future Starship tanks. Here you can see that SN6 is obviously still sitting in the mid bay but has a friend next to it, which is that 4 ring stack we saw recently. Also spotted was a new ring stack that has been moved out of a fabrication tent. This barrel section also partially has those internal reinforcements that we usually see on thrust sections. Also, just behind it you can see that there is another section in the tent being constructed which is similar. Then, there was also another tapered section spotted moving near to the other nose cones. Could SpaceX be in the process of building yet another new nose cone? It would be crazy if that's the case. To finish up the video, we'll take a look at something that we've not seen for a while, a build diagram. This one is not from the usual diagram producer as he's been busy recently, but somebody called Brendan on Twitter created this. Keep in mind that the new fairing section may not be for SN8, especially since it has no header tank. However, this is the progress of the SN8 tanks and next up is just stacking. I'm just going to throw this in quick, there are some new stickers available on the SpaceXFans shop. In future, I want to add 3D printed Starships, clothing and more, link in the description. As always though, none of these detailed and frequent updates would be possible without Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, going out there and filming. She and the whole NASA spaceflight team put in an immense amount of work to bring us phenomenal views. Thank you all so much. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.